Good morning. I'm Maureen Kyle with your 3 News Now morning update. Today is Thursday, June 10th, and we have tons of news to get to. But our weather team is still tracking some pop-up storms, so we start with Holly.
Thanks so much, Maureen. And into the rest of the afternoon, we are tracking more of those pop-up downpours, showers, thunderstorms. This is the view through the afternoon and evening. And again, it's going to be pretty random as far as where, but we're definitely seeing more numerous showers and thunderstorms as we head through the afternoon and evening hours. Then things more or less fade, and we do it all over again for your Friday. So we start off dry, and then we see more showers and thunderstorms as we look towards the afternoon and evening hours. The good news is as we get into the weekend, we are starting off Saturday. As you notice here, this is 7 a.m. Saturday, and it is beautifully dry, and we are going to be seeing some sunshine. We'll talk more about the weekend in just a sec. In the meantime, for the rest of today, can't rule out a downpour, a storm, really at any point. Low 80s for highs, and yes, in between all of that, we are seeing some sunshine. And then looking ahead to a very similar Friday, drier this weekend, but there is the chance of rain, perhaps a few rumbles Saturday night into early Sunday. But the good news there is that during the day Saturday and then after, you know, the morning hours on Sunday, we get the dry weather. And speaking of dry weather, next week is looking spectacular so far. Maureen, back to you.
All right, Holly, looking great. Thanks so much. Well, in developing news, the superintendent of Canton City Schools is responding to the accusations of recently fired McKinley High School football coach Marcus Watley. Superintendent Jeff Talbert said in a video statement that the district did nothing wrong when it voted to dismiss Watley and 6 of his assistants.
These false accusations go against the very fabric of who we are as an institution of learning that is dedicated to student achievement and success. As a part of the investigation, the district viewed security video footage of the incident. This video footage is extensive, and it clearly shows the identified coaches engaging in actions that constituted inappropriate, demeaning, and divisive behavior in a misguided attempt to instill discipline in our student athletes.
The superintendent is stressing that the safety and well-being of their students is the number one priority.
I'm a Cleveland Browns coach.
Okay.
This is detrimental to my career. I'm great at my house. I'd love to just go home, sir.
Now to the developing story of Brown's chief of staff, Callie Brownson, arrested in Brunswick back in May. That was newly released dashcam video from the arrest. We now know she won't lose her job over the incident, but she was not at practice yesterday. Head coach Kevin Stefanski says she's still on the job, but temporarily suspended. Brownson pleaded no contest in court to a charge of OVI. Brownson's blood alcohol level was twice the legal limit when she was pulled over. The Browns organization says they did not take the issue lightly, and they wrestled with how to discipline Brownson and have been in close contact with the NFL about what to do as far as disciplinary action. Stefanski says Brownson knows what she did was extremely wrong.
She's extremely remorseful. I've spoken to her many times, and she'll learn from this, and hopefully we'll all be in a better place after this. But I'm disappointed. She's disappointed, and again, we'll just work through all the particulars.
So how long will her suspension last? The Browns practice tomorrow and then the next 3 days. But then they will have a long break until training camp at the end of July. And the hope is that Brownson can return at that point.
Klein from Richwood, you just won $1 million in the Vax-a-Million giveaway. Congratulations to you. And our lucky Ohio student winner, Sarah Afane from Sheffield Lake. Congratulations.
There you have it. 2 more winners in the Ohio Vax-a-Million lottery, and one is from Lorain County. Governor DeWine tweeted out pictures of him FaceTiming Sarah, who is a 7th grader at Brookside Middle School. The Sheffield School superintendent tells us that she is a fantastic young lady with an amazing family as well. While she couldn't speak with us, we did catch up with the lucky $1 million winner who's already making plans.
One of the things I told the governor, I really loved that they were giving scholarships as part of this. So I might do something you know, for to put some money towards some scholarships for kids.
There are now just two more chances left to win. You can register at OhioVax-a-Million.com. And according to the state, over 3,362,000 Ohioans are entered in the drawing for the $1 million prize. And over 143,000 Ohioans aged 12 to 17 are entered for the scholarship drawing. The number of entries in both groups from last week to this week's drawing increased, with more than 136,000 additional adult entries and over 10,000 additional student entries. And speaking of vaccines, the U.S. has agreed to purchase 500 million doses of the Pfizer coronavirus vaccine, and they will be sent overseas. The U.S. will distribute 200 million of the doses this year, and the remaining 300 million will be distributed in the first half of 2022. They will be distributed through COVAX and will go to 92 lower-income countries and the African Union. President Biden is expected to make the announcement at the G7 summit later today. And good news for Cedar Point. Park officials say they are getting back on track with summer hiring, telling 3 News that applications have returned to pre-pandemic levels. Officials say for now, the park will remain closed on Tuesdays and Wednesdays through June 23rd, but they're hopeful that they'll get more people hired quickly. We have some exciting news this morning and some adorable video. The Cleveland Metro Park Zoo newest baby orangutan officially has a name. We introduce you to Zaki. And part of the voting process included a donation to the Future for Wildlife Fund. Thanks to everybody participating, the vote campaign raised nearly $15,000 for orangutan conservation efforts. Annette Face. Oh my goodness. Can't wait to see it in person. Well, thank you so much for joining us for this 3 News Now morning update. You can stay tuned online and on our WKYC app as our weather team continues to track showers and thunderstorms. I'm Maureen Kyle, and we'll see you Friday morning on GO starting at 4:30 a.m. Have a great day, everyone.